We're talking about switching mode power supplies, or SMPS, with Jamie in the NV Application Center.
Switching mode power supplies are widely used because of their power density, efficiency, and reliability. Today, we'll look at SMPS technology and new 2.5 kV MSOP isolators that enable better than ever power supplies. So just like you evolved.
Hey, that's not me.
Sorry. SMPS technology has evolved from non-synchronous buck converters to synchronous rectification. Synchronous rectification has evolved from self-synchronized to controller-driven. Synchronous gate drive isolation is the most challenging isolation element in modern SMPS. It's gone from pulse transformers to optocouplers to digital isolators such as isoloop spintronic isolators. Some pros and cons of the design approaches. Non-synchronous converters rely on Schottky diodes. Forward diode drops mean inefficiencies. The losses are even more significant with newer, low-voltage supplies. Self-synchronized rectification uses the AC waveform to switch the MOSFETs. It's simple, but inefficient, because it's not well-synchronized and doesn't drive the MOSFET on resistance as low as it could be. Controller-driven, synchronous rectification is the preferred design because it provides excellent synchronization, which maximizes efficiency, but it requires fast isolation.
We'll get back to isolation, but are SMPS designs complicated?
So simple, a caveman can do it. Here's a typical circuit. Key components are a pulse width modulation controller, switching MOSFETs, synchronous rectifier MOSFETs, MOSFET gate drivers, gate driver isolation, and an error amplifier and linear isolator. Optocouplers remain popular here because next generation digital isolators aren't suited for analog.
You're working on that. So, what about digital isolators?
There are three types of non-optical digital isolators. Inductive, capacitive, and spintronic. Inductive isolators have limited pulse position accuracy because carrier frequencies limit accuracy and the high frequency signaling causes EMI emissions. Device life is better than optos at 50 to 100 years, but, of course, there's a statistical chance of any particular device failing much sooner. Capacitive isolators are also imprecise and generate EMI, and their rated life is only 13 years. Spintronic isolators have excellent precision because they're not clocked, low emissions because they do not have carriers or refresh clocks, are the smallest with MSOP 8s available, and have a remarkable 44,000-year life.
Why is precision so important in SMPS?
Gate drivers and isolators need to be many times faster than the switching frequency. Speed and precision improve efficiency. Here's why. Propagation delay causes the MOSFET to turn on and off after the zero crossings. That means the first part of the waveform isn't used, and there's energy loss from a negative voltage here. Channel-to-channel skew also causes inefficiencies. With a skew, neither MOSFET is on, so the AC energy is lost. This type of skew is even worse because both MOSFETs are on, which means no net energy transfer, and there are ohmic losses from the MOSFETs fighting each other. Spintronic isolators have best-in-class speed and precision specifications.
Now I understand precision. Let's get back to reliability. You said spintronic isolators have a 44,000-year life. So you've had parts on life test since the Pleistocene epoch.
Well, since the Clinton administration, with standard, it's extrapolations. Here's a comparison of isolator life specs.
So where are spintronic isolators?
We need to expand the scale quite a bit. Past the industrial age, the pyramids, great civilizations, the first settlements, farming.
Is that a woolly mammoth?
Yes. We're talking serious MTBF here.
Well, thanks for that powerful information, Jamie. Where can I buck up with more?
Get in sync at nvu.com for data sheets and reference designs.